Welcome back to part 7 of A Beautiful Game. This is the Karma Rendering series, and in this part, we're going over motion blur. Now, motion blur is generally a pretty straightforward topic. However, because we're now working in Solaris, there are a few extra things that we kind of need to keep in mind. So this is going to be a shorter tutorial, but I think it's best that it's separate so that it's easy to find. It's now concise and a separate part. So for all of your motion blur needs, we now have this tutorial. Okay, so you can go ahead and open up the part7_motionblur.hip file. Now keep in mind, you will have needed to download the cache that comes with this. So because we are covering volume motion blur, you are going to be needing the cache. Okay, so we can go ahead and dive inside of this motion blur LOPNet. And inside of here, we just have a bunch of things. So we're referencing in some pieces. If we take a look, it's just this bishop and rook. Over here, we have two transforms. We have one for the rook and one for the bishop. The idea of this is that the bishop is taking the rook, right? So it's actually just very basic, nothing fancy going on there. And then we have the smoke down here so that upon impact, the rook turns to smoke, right? So nothing crazy. It's a fairly basic simulation, fairly basic animation. Over here, we have a material library for the smoke. We'll get into that. And then we have our three lights, our camera, a merge node, and our karma output node at the bottom. So if we go to our camera one, this is the view that we have. So this is a case where you'd want motion blur, right? You'd want this piece that's moving over here to have motion blur, and you'd want the smoke to have motion blur. So how exactly do we go about getting motion blur? And it falls more or less into two camps. You have what is motion blur, and then you have what is velocity blur. Now, velocity blur relies on an attribute. So that attribute may be the V attribute or the VEL attribute if you're talking about VDBs and vector grids. So to simplify that, if you have geometry, you either have motion blur, where it is based on their movement, or you have velocity blur, where it is based on a V attribute. And if you have a volume, that velocity blur is based on the VEL VDB grid. So let's go into this and understand those concepts. So the first thing that we have are these static pieces, right? So these are all static pieces that we're bringing in. So there would be no velocity on them, right? There's no velocity attribute being brought in. We then have these two transforms. So obviously there's no velocity being generated, right? We're not adding a velocity attribute. And so if we go ahead and render, I'm just going to remove the important node that I'll get back to, but I'm going to remove that node and we can try and see if we have some motion blur. Let's go ahead to our karma final and just go to a frame where this is moving and take a look at what we have. Also just going to disable the smoke for now. It's not really necessary. Okay, so as you can see, we have depth of field as the background's blurring, but we don't have any motion blur. Now, why is that? Because if we look over here, we can clearly see that we have motion blur, and on our karma render node, this is on by default. Now, the reason we don't have motion blur is because motion blur is dependent on this movement, and Solaris views each frame as a separate frame. So what you would need to do is you would need to actually cache all of these frames and then let it calculate motion from there. So to do that, after all of your motion has been done, you can drop down a cache node. So just a cache node, and you can put it after your motion right over here. Over here, you can just say always cache all frames. What that'll do is it'll always calculate the cache. Now, you may notice some very subtle motion blur. It may be difficult to see, but if we go over to our camera, we can change the shutter open and shutter close. So these two values basically define how fast the shutter on our virtual camera opens and closes. So if you have the shutter open for a longer time, you'll get more motion blur. So if we just change this to some extreme value, like -10 and 10, you can see that we have that extreme motion blur, right? And if we disable our cache node, we no longer have that motion blur. So that is motion blur, right? That is independent of velocity blur. If we disable velocity blur over here, so no velocity blur, you'll notice we still have motion blur, right? So those are two separate concepts. Velocity blur and motion blur are two separate things. So I'm going to just set this back to a much smaller value, something like -0.8 to 0.8, just that we can still see that it's on, but it's nothing too distracting or extreme. Now that's one thing, and that's okay, but what happens if we want to use this velocity blur? Well, to do that, I'm actually going to go up a level to our SOP level. So let's go ahead and create a geonode. Inside of this geonode, I'm just going to call this sphere motion. Right, in here, I'm going to create a sphere. I'm going to scale this down to about 0.1, just over there, and move it up a bit. So we're just going to move it to about 0.1, like that. We're then going to add an attribute wrangle, and we're going to give this some fake velocity, so no movement, right? We're just going to use an attribute. We're going to say v at v equals, and then we're just going to give it some velocity, 0, 1, 2, right? So the velocity, if you view the velocity trails, it's just like that. So that's the direction you'd expect your motion blur to be in. If we go back into our LOP network, we can use a SOP import node over here to bring that sphere in. So over on the side here, we're just going to bring in our sphere. So the whole node, just like that. And we can plug it into this chain over here. So now you can see our sphere, and that's pretty massive. So I'm just going to scale this down even further, 0.025. Something like that. So it's quite small, right? You can see it over there in the background. If we view this from our camera, we have it there in the background. Now I'm going to go over here to this comma final node and activate our velocity blur. So if we activate velocity blur over here, you would expect to see some motion blur. So let's see what we get. And as you can see, that's exactly what we're getting, right? So we have no actual motion on that, but we have the velocity attribute that defines its movement. So if we set this to no velocity blur, you can see that that no longer has motion blur, but our bishop up front still does, because that is still working on the cached motion blur. Okay, so we can get rid of our sphere over there. And now let's move on to smoke. So we have this smoke over here, and I'm just going to skip ahead to a later frame where our smoke is nicely in motion, something like that. Okay. So the smoke I actually set up as material X. If you want to know how to do that, you can check out the next part. I'll be explaining all of that. I'll be going into this material library and explaining how to build a material X volume. It's a little bit unintuitive if you haven't worked with it before. So going through that might be helpful if you're interested. Okay, so once again, I've disabled this velocity blur. If we take a look at our velocity blur over here, it may be hard to notice, but if we go once again to our camera and kind of make this pretty extreme, we can take a look at what we have. Okay, so as you can see, this volume is getting blurred quite hectically. And the reason for that is because we do actually have a velocity on our VDB. So if we take a look over here, we have smoke, inside of it we have volume, and that volume is comprised of a density and a velocity. Now to really test this, what you can do is you can drop a prune node over here. And what we're going to do is we're just going to disable our velocity. So over here, we're going to say deactivate as the method. And for the primitive pattern, we're just going to drag in our velocity grid. As you can see, that removes the velocity grid and we no longer have velocity blur. Right? So velocity blur is always based on the attribute. Once again, if we re-enable this, our velocity is now active again and we can use it for motion blur. So same thing goes for instance velocity blur. If you have instances that need velocity blur, you'll activate it over here. So if they have a V attribute, they'll use this. And once again, over here, you can see that we also have the volume velocity blur scale. So if we drop this down over here on our shutter, so just to the base values, and then we increase this volume velocity blur scale to something like 100, you end up with a very similar situation. So the default value of 1 should be fine. Cool. So that's all that really goes into motion blur. So just to reiterate on what we did, if you have an attribute or a VDB grid or velocity, you will use that with velocity blur. You'll have to enable velocity blur on the comma output node. If you have motion but no velocity attribute, you can use the cache node to cache that motion and use it for motion blur. So those are the two main ways of generating motion blur. I hope that that helps you. And if you're interested in how to create the smoke shader and how to render smoke, we will be looking at that in the next part. So I hope to see you there, and I hope this was helpful. So I will see you next time. Bye.